Hello, this is Onyx Tarot, and today I'm going to be doing a love message for Scorpio. So thank you all so much for hitting the like button, subscribing. I really do appreciate it. Let's go ahead and get a love message from Scorpio's person. All right. So Scorpio, we have I shouldn't have ruined this connection. All right. So there's somebody here in your energy here who feels like they're very regretful that they messed up some type of connection. This could be somebody that right now is having a really hard time, especially at night when they sit and think about the things that they did wrong. I feel like this person, maybe you gave this person ample opportunities to change and ample opportunities to do something different. And I feel like after, I'm hearing like the third time, after you realized they weren't going to change, I feel like you ended some type of connection and pulled back from this person. Three of swords, six of pentacles reversed. So it looks like this person right now is they're not used to you setting boundaries with them or not really agreeing with them. They're not used to you just being all like kind of like strictly business with them. But I feel like you want to kind of protect your energy, and also I feel like you're kind of on the fence. Okay, never mind. Three of wands. I feel like you are moving on from this person completely. Okay, three of wands. March could have been important, or the number three could be important, but I feel like you put this behind you and somebody is like coming towards you to kind of fight for you, and also to kind of like fight for you to see their perspective. I feel like this is somebody that you broke up with. This month could have been important as well. Or this is somebody who you weren't necessarily super happy with as the relationship kept going along. Magician reverse, you could have kind of felt like this person wasn't who they said they were, if that makes sense. And I also feel like you, maybe there was a part where you're like, I don't know, maybe I should stay with this person. Maybe I should keep developing my connection with this person. And I feel like you kind of realize they're not going to change. Okay, so this person's kind of like stuck in their ways. Right now I feel like they're in the seven of pentacles, where they're like pondering and they're like, ooh, how do I get Scorpio back? But I feel like every time they communicate with you, they are not getting the answers that they want from you. Because why? Ten of swords. Looks like you are done with this connection. Okay, what is this person's next steps towards Scorpio? The Hermit reverse, Ace of Pentacles reverse, Two of Pentacles reverse, and the Nine of Wands. So I feel like if you haven't really heard too much from this person, like maybe you started communicating less, they're going to be calling you more. They're going to be texting you more. They're going to be reaching out to you more. I feel like this person still at the same time does not have anything solid to offer you. It looks like there's a missed opportunity. And it looks like as well, they kind of want to, I don't know, it's almost like they want to offer you a missed opportunity, or like they don't have anything else to offer you. So it looks like, if anything, yeah, Two of Pentacles reverse, it feels like they may sabotage any kind of friendship that you guys have left by trying to be controlling and trying to be toxic, or try to basically trap you in a situation to where it's harder for you to make some type of decision. So it'll be really important as this person, you know, as you're communicating with this person, that's how you'll know what you're reading. Okay. If you are actively communicating with this person, kind of still friends with them. And if not, this isn't your reading, and you know, maybe the next one will resonate, but like, I don't know, this person, when they come towards you, trust your gut, but at the same time, it looks like they're trying to do all the things to basically make sure that you don't go anywhere, that you don't go too far. But it looks like, I'm not sure if they're actually have changed, if they have actually changed. It doesn't look like it. Temperance reverse. But again, that'll be up to you. Okay. So let's get some advice for Scorpio. Advice for Scorpio. All right, so we have romance and then yes. So I feel like a lot of you guys are in new connections and you're meeting someone new completely. I feel like this person, like, really think about if you are in love with this person, okay? Are you in love with them? Do you like the way that they communicate to you? Do you like the way that they, how they talk to you? Do you like their emotional maturity? Okay. Do you feel like this is a very happy person, or do you feel like they're kind of like, you know, the reason why they're not happy, right? Think about all those things and think about if this is somebody that you actually want to be with. Also, I feel like if that's the case, then you should move forward towards, you know, making yourself happy and doing things that make you happy. Like I said, a lot of you guys have a new commitment here, okay? Nine of Cups reverse, Five of Pentacles reverse, and the Lovers. You could already be in a relationship right now or a connection right now with someone with Gemini and their Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus. But I feel like there's some type of chance, an opportunity for you to move forward in a brand new connection, but it may be really important for you to analyze and realize if you want to end a connection or end communication or end however that resonates with the past person so that you can move towards with a new person. So that'll be up to you, but I feel like that'll be important to decide. Because it's almost like you don't want your happiness to be stunted, or your happiness of meeting someone new that you're passionate about, you're very attracted to, you've sparked this new connection with. It's almost like there's not enough room for two energies. There's not enough room for this Nine of Wands who's not going to leave you alone. You know what I'm saying? Not literally, you know, but like Nine of Wands, they're fighting for this connection. They're like, okay, you don't want to be with me? Okay, maybe tomorrow. Okay, not tomorrow. Okay, maybe next year. Okay, I'll wait for next year. This person is like, they are in super regret. And I feel like they're utilizing this time to prolong the inevitable. But at the same time, it's like there's someone new. There's new love. That's a confirmation for a new connection here. But at the same time, I feel like it's going to be hard to communicate and stay on top of, or stay on, you know, energetically in a good place as far as a past person and a new person. Okay, so feel free to let me know your thoughts if that resonates with you. Thank you for hitting the like button, subscribing, and thank you for watching.